New York. I love New York City. I make no bones about it. I know it's trendy for everybody not in New York City to dump on the place. I think it's an absolute blast. I've always loved it my entire life. What happened? Is it just a de Blasio problem? Because I've seen it. I'll tell you, I've had to visit there once every 6 months or so for a while, and it's just going this way quickly. Why?
Well, look, I think it starts with lessons not learned in youth. And so you have an entire generation of people who didn't learn what I learned at a very young age, which is that just because somebody's not charging you for the lunch doesn't mean that it's actually free. You know, the same people who are talking about labor should be rewarded don't seem to understand that there is labor that goes into their free college, there is labor that goes into their free housing, and that when you don't pay for that labor and when you don't pay for the infrastructure that supports it, states go bankrupt. And bankrupt states and bankrupt cities hurt people. So when you try to spend money that you don't have, Republicans push back on it. That's not us being mean. That's us literally trying to save an entire generation of seniors from senior abuse, an entire generation of children from child abuse. And until we're able to confront that stark reality, the fact remains we're going to end up on this road to nowhere where all that's there is pain and suffering for the people that depend on government the most.
I need somebody to merge this world for me. New York, I'm being told the movers in New York are flat out telling people no because they have too much work to do. So many people are moving out. So you have people who move out can afford to move out because moving is expensive. So you're losing your tax base. You're running out your tax base. And at the same time, New York is one of the most expensive places in America to live. How does this end in anything else but disaster if everyone who can afford to packs up and leaves?
Well, look, I mean, here's the truth. I mean, people with means can always find ways to game the system. I think that's something that most Republicans and Democrats can agree upon. And I think that the hard truth is that when you start talking about how does this end, you don't have to look any further than what happened already in New York in a place like Rochester, in a place like Buffalo. These were thriving communities. That again, through abject neglect, became ghost towns. You're looking at places like Detroit, places that again were thriving communities that through too much neglect, through Democrats trying to be everything to everybody, end up becoming ghost towns, basically becoming repositories for pain and despair, mansions to oppression. This is what Democrats have built for us, town to town, city to city. And now they flee places like New York City and they take their bad policies with them to low tax places like Texas and Florida. And then we have to sit here fretting about the fact that those places might be going from red to purple to blue. So this is a recurring cycle that I think we'll never be able to truly root out until we as Republicans, I think, again, start providing solutions to the problems Democrats have tried to fix poorly. That means dealing with the issue of poverty. We have to be out front with solutions for poverty because we know conservative solutions have always been the best way to combat poverty. We know that the solutions that Democrats put forth, like socialism, have always led to more pain, despair, despots, all the types of things that they claim that the Republicans are now the embodiment of, when in reality, they are the ones that are attempting to usher it in. So, look, I don't have a simple answer for you, but I think the hard truth is that it is up to us to fix it. That as much as we might not like it, Democrats are a part of America. And if we believe in conservatism being the vehicle for America, it is up to conservatives to wrestle control from those who do not understand what has always worked from the beginning of time.
Hey, thanks so much for watching The First on YouTube. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and like and subscribe. You heard me, like it, subscribe. You'll get a lot more of it and a lot more of me.